The pseudocode algorithm shown has been written by a teacher to enter marks for the students in our class, and then to apply some simple processing. Question A says, describe what happens in this algorithm. We have a pseudocode algorithm over here, which we need to read through and understand how it works. When we're describing what happens in an algorithm, the main thing that we don't want to do is to describe what happens on each line. So, for example, we don't want to start off by saying, a count variable is initialized to zero, a repeat loop is started, a value is then input into an array. We wouldn't get any marks for effectively translating each line of the pseudocode into English. We need to describe what this algorithm accomplishes and how it does it. Here's a reminder to not translate each line of the code into English. When looking at the pseudocode, there are a few things we should notice. The first thing is the notation of using these square brackets. You should recognize this as an array. And combined with the input keyword, this means that the program asks the user to enter a value, and the value is stored within this array called score. Let's write down some of the attributes of the pseudocode to keep track of them. The first thing we have is an array called score. You may notice on this line, we're accessing an array called grade, using the same formatting of this square bracket. Let's write that down. The next thing to notice is that we have a repeat until loop that has an exit condition with a variable called count. This variable count is initialized to zero at the beginning and is incremented by one on each iteration of our loop. This means that this repeat until loop is going to loop 30 times, since it terminates when count reaches 30. Let's write that down. The next thing to notice is that we have this structure called a nested if statement, where we have if statements that exist within other if statements. You can see this first if statement has a connecting else. Then within this else, we have another if statement, and this pattern continues. Let's write that down. The next thing to notice is that for each if statement, we are comparing the same variable score at the position of count. The condition contains a single comparison, where we're using the same operator of greater than or equal to. The only difference between these conditions is this value that is being compared to. You can see it starts at 70 and decreases down to 30. Finally, we could notice that for each if statement, if the condition is true, a string value is assigned to a position within this array called grade. This also happens in every single if statement, where the only difference we have is the value that is being assigned to this array. In order to figure out what is being input by the pseudocode algorithm, we can take a look at the question. This means that the teacher is going to be entering numbers on this input line. Since this input line exists within this loop, we can say that we're entering 30 marks into this array. Let's go ahead and write that down. First off, marks are entered and stored in the array called score. 30 marks are entered and stored in total. When we enter a single mark into the array, this mark is then taken and tested against a number of values in these nested if statements, as noted in our attributes. The mark is first tested to see if it is greater than or equal to 70. If this condition is true, in other words, if the mark is greater than or equal to 70, we then assign the string value of A to the array called grade at the position of count. If this initial condition is false, we would go to the else and we'd continue along the nested if statement. The easiest way to understand a nested if statement is to run it using some test data and see what happens. So let's try two different values. It doesn't really matter what these values are, as long as they're numbers. So let's try the values 65 and 20. If the teacher enters the first value 65, 65 is then compared to 70. The condition would look like this. 65 greater than or equal to 70. This is obviously a false statement, so the if statement would evaluate false, and we'd go down to the else. That same value, 65, is compared to 60. The condition would look like this. 65 is greater than or equal to 60, so this is a true statement, meaning the if statement is evaluated to true. So we would then go to the line inside the if statement, which assigns the string value of B to the grade count. So when we enter 65, we would store the value of B. Let's try 20. 20 would initially be stored in the array score at the position of count. 20 would then be compared to 70. So the condition would look like this. 20 greater than or equal to 70. This is a false statement, meaning we would go down to the else statement. Inside the else, we would evaluate the next if statement, which checks the same value of 20 against 60. 20 is not greater than or equal to 60. So again, we'd go to the next else. Inside this else, we have another if statement, which checks if that same value of 20 is greater than or equal to 50. Again, that's false. So we'd go down. We have yet another if statement, which checks if 20 is greater than or equal to 40. Again, this is false. So we keep going. The last if statement then checks if 20 is greater than or equal to 30. That is still false. So we'd go to the last else statement. And within the last else statement, the string value of f is assigned to the array grade at position count. You can do more test examples if you're still unsure what's going on, but you should be able to infer that we are assigning grades to matching ranges of marks. Marks that are greater than or equal to 70 are given an A grade. Marks that are between 60 and 70 are given a B grade. Marks that are between 50 and 60 are given a C grade, and so on and so on, until we get down to an F grade. Let's go ahead and write down our findings. Marks are checked against a range of boundaries and a matching grade is assigned to each mark. This grade is going to be stored in the array of grade. Let's write that down. The grade is stored in the array grade at the same index as the mark input. We say at the same index because count is keeping track of the indexes of the array. The first value is entered into the array called score at the index of 0, since count is initialized to 0. We then check this mark against the range of boundaries, and whatever grade is chosen, it is assigned to the grade array at the position of 0, the same position as the data entered. You may notice that this question is only for 3 marks, but we've given quite a bit of information here. This amount of points is not necessary to get all 3 marks. I've written down about 6 marks worth of points. You can see the mark allocation over here. So fortunately, you would only need to write down 3 points about this algorithm. The main thing to take away from this is to not just translate each line of pseudocode into English, and instead to describe what the algorithm accomplishes and how it does it. And there we go. That is this question completed.